Hey guys, Glenn here. This just in, this is the Helix LT. I was really excited when I heard about this thing released a couple of days ago. Yeah, Line 6 was really hush-hush about this, I don't know why, but this thing is amazing. So it's basically, it's a Helix, it's a full-blown Helix with a little few less IOs and things like that. You've still got digital AES EVU or Line 6 link. You still got the Variax VDI connection here. You've got a phone jack. And I mean, basically, I run XLR stereo to the front of house, and then I split either a mono or a stereo line either to a Marshall amp and cab, or a couple of cabs and Marshalls, or if smaller gigs, I use the Line 6 Firehawk 1500. Which is a great FR rig paired with the Helix. You've still got two effects sends and two effects returns. You can run a stereo effects processor in the loop if you want, or you can run two pedals if you like. So you still, but honestly, I tried that when I first got the Helix, and I found that I didn't need any more pedals. All the pedals I needed were in the Helix, and they sounded so good. Extra pedals for me just seemed like overkill. So then you got your guitar, and you still got one more expression pedal jack, and I actually got one of those Mission Engineering expression pedals that's designed specifically for the Helix, and the price is good too, so I picked up one of those. The first thing I did when I got this was the pedal was a little too stiff here, so I got an Allen wrench that comes with it, and I loosened this about a quarter of a turn, and that did the trick. Next thing I did was I put one of my screen protectors on here first thing. So these ones I make for the Helix, they fit perfectly on the LT. And then I had in mind to do some labels. So these are my own custom labels, and I'll show you those in a minute. So you just heard how it sounds. It sounds pretty darn good. I mean, it's just like the Helix. It's the full-blown Helix brain is in this thing, okay? There's a couple of things you don't have. For example, in the Helix, when you press this mode switch, you had 10 switches that... Okay, sorry, my battery just went out. Where was I? Okay, the switches. Okay, so on the Helix, if you press this mode switch, you'd have 10 switches that you could assign different effects too. On this one, you can't do that with these two switches, so that's one less feature. But honestly, I use four snapshots, and four on the top row is different effects on and off, and for me that's enough. The way I design these labels is this one would always be a drive, this one would always be a modulation, and this one would always be some sort of delay. So when you're making your patches, if for one patch you want a chorus here, and the next patch you want a phaser, you can change patches, or you can do, you know, phaser, chorus, filter, reverb if you want. You can make these anything you want is my point here. And then I run it with the snapshots on the bottom, and I'm going to show you how to set those up. So, next thing I did. Got my Velcro ready for the board. Now, another good thing about this unit is there's no vents on the bottom. The Helix has vents, If you block those things off, it's going to get hot. No vents on this. I was surprised to see that. So I'm really loving this black case, man. It's rugged too. It's steel. It's not aluminum. Sucker's hefty. Very hefty. So let me show you a little bit closer the interface and everything. I'll let you check it out. Okay, guys, let me just go over a few things here. Well, first of all, first thing I did when I got the pedal was this volume pedal was really, really stiff. So I took the Allen wrench on the side here and I loosened it about a quarter turn. That made it perfect to where I think I like it now. Now, as you can see, on the top row, I have stomps, and on the bottom row, I have snapshots. And you can see that in the screen here. See the bottom row snapshots, top row is four stomps. Now, the way you do that is you go into the global settings, and then you go into foot switches, and you set them like this. The preset mode switches should be set to stomp snap, okay? Auto return snapshot mode switches, you can leave that there, and banks up and down switches. On the regular Helix, you've got a few more options here. Now, first thing I did was this LED light. When you get the unit, it's going to be flashing. It's very distracting. If you don't use tap tempo, which I don't, so that's how you take that off. You go into the displays and you turn the tap tempo LED to off. It'll shut off like that. Now, let me briefly show you my pedal board stickers. These are going to be out tomorrow. If you want to order them, they'll go out in 2 days. You're going to get them in an envelope like this, okay? And they're going to come in a sealed plastic envelope like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 14, 20, 30. So you've got a lot of different stickers here. You've got several copies if you want to change things around. If you like the symbols, I have the symbols. You can see that. If you like these symbols, that you know that this is drive, this is delay, this is reverb, you can use those, which I have these. So in my patches, there's always going to be a drive here, there's always going to be a modulation, and there's always going to be a delay here for most of my patches for this particular board. So let me show you how these work. Now, all you're going to need, I'm going to go ahead and let's peel this one off. Peel them off, you just pick it up with your nail and peel it off. It won't leave any residue. It comes off in one piece just like that. So I'm gonna give you a little piece of this backing material here. And this is how you put them on. All right, so I know I want the delay symbol back there, so I've got one right here. So you take the backing piece here and you go to the delay sticker and you just kind of lightly lift it up like that. And then you grab this, make sure you're using the wax paper side. Grab it like that, peel it off of the page, and use this piece as to kind of stabilize it. Put it into place and press it down. That's it. That's all there is to it. It works very well. So like I say, you're gonna get them in this this envelope like this, and I can send these all over the world. I can send them to pretty much any country, and I've already sent my screen protectors, which is on here. Probably can't even tell. It's on there. I've already sent those to about 21 different countries all over the world. So same with these. You will see on my website, you'll have a link for the United States and then another link for all other countries. So if you're interested in getting these, it's kind of like having scribble strips, like on the Helix itself. But I'm really liking this black top finish. I really like that. It's got a really sleek look to it. So
Most of you guys already know how to assign these switches. It's very easy. Let's just go. Let's put a Minotaur here, and I'm gonna assign it to the drive, this drive pedal right here, which is my drive switch. All you do is just tap it like that, and you hit OK. Boom, and there it is. You can turn it on and off. It's very simple to use, just like the Helix. There's a bunch of videos about that.
Well, so that was my little video on the Line 6. Helix LT just came out yesterday, I believe, and tell you what, I'm really excited for Line 6. They're gonna do well with this pedal. It's $500 cheaper than its big brother, the Helix, but you get the same sounds. You still get XLR stereo out, you still get quarter inch stereo out, you still got a stereo effect send and return, and an expression pedal jack, so there's still a lot you can do with this board. And I'm gonna be doing some more demos here and there in the future as time permits. So again, all of my patches that are available for the Helix will work in this particular LT board. That's the first thing I did when I got it. I upgraded the firmware because it was at 2.12. Upgraded the firmware really quick, no hiccups, just went right away, it worked. Started loading my IR, started loading my patches, I loaded everything. Everything worked first shot. It was totally compatible with the Helix and the LT. The patches are totally compatible. So if you want to pick those up, you can get those on my website. And again, about these labels, those will go out in a couple of days. I'm going to have the link out there tomorrow morning on my website if you're interested in picking those up. And guys, please remember to leave your address when you order these labels, if you want to order them, and also the screen protectors. Make sure you leave your address, please, so I'll know where to send them. And until next time, guys, thank you so much for your continued support, and rock on.